Artificial intelligence is what?
It's just digital intelligence. And as the algorithms and the hardware improve, that digital intelligence will exceed biological intelligence by a substantial margin. It's obvious.
When you say that we'll exceed human intelligence, at some point soon, the machine's going to be smart, not just smarter, like exponentially smarter than any of us.
Ensuring that the advent of AI is good, or at least we try to make it good, seems like a smart move.
But we're way behind on that.
Yes, we're not paying attention. We worry more about what name somebody called someone else than whether AI will destroy humanity. That's insane.
This could be a huge problem for society. What are the scenarios that scare you most?
Humanity really is not evolved to think of existential threats in general. We're evolved to think about things that are very close to us, near term, to be upset with other humans, and not to really to think about things that could destroy humanity as a whole. But then in recent decades, just really in the last century, we had nuclear bombs, which could potentially destroy civilization, obviously. We have AI, which could destroy civilization. We have global warming, which could destroy civilization, or at least severely disrupt civilization.
How could AI destroy civilization?
You know, it would be something the same way that humans destroyed the habitat of primates. I mean, it wouldn't necessarily be destroyed, but we might be relegated to a small corner of the world. When Homo sapiens became much smarter than other primates, it pushed all the other ones into small habitats. They're just in the way. You could make a swarm of assassin drones for very little money by just taking the Face ID chip that's used in cell phones and having a small explosive charge and a standard drone, and have them just do a grid sweep of the building until they find the person they're looking for, ram into them and explode. You could do that right now. No new technology is needed right now. Probably a bigger risk than being hunted down by a drone is that AI would be used to make incredibly effective propaganda that would not seem like propaganda.
So these are deep fakes.
Yeah, influence the direction of society, influence elections, artificial intelligence. Just hones the message, looks at the feedback, makes this message slightly better. Within milliseconds, it can adapt its message and shift and react to news. And there's so many social media accounts out there that are not people. How do you know it's a person, not a person?
One reason that regulators and others are a little bit in denial about this is the speed, the pace of change. What is the consequence of that speed of change?
The way in which a regulation is put in place is slow and linear.
Right.
And we are facing an exponential threat. And if you have a linear response to an exponential threat, it's quite likely the exponential threat will win. That, in a nutshell, is the issue. The long-term aspiration for Neuralink would be to achieve a symbiosis with artificial intelligence and to achieve a sort of democratization of intelligence such that it is not monopolistically held in a purely digital form by governments and large corporations.
Basically, an effort for man to merge with machine in
yes.
a healthy way.
Yes.
To beat machines, you basically have to merge with machines.
Most likely, yes. Essentially, how do we ensure that the future constitutes the sum of the will of humanity? And so if we have billions of people with the high bandwidth link to the AI extension of themselves, it would actually make everyone hyper smart. And by the way, you kind of have this already in a weird way, in that you have a digital tertiary layer in the form of your phone, your computers. You basically have these computing devices that form a tertiary layer on your cognition already. Talking about, okay, what would it take to really solve for spinal cord injuries? We already know how to do this. Implant electrodes into the motor cortex of the brain. And then bypass the severed section of the spine and have effectively local microcontrollers near the muscle groups. It could restore full limb functionality. Very exciting what can be done here. And then just memory. Like, as people get older, they lose their memory. And it's the thing. It's like, it's incredibly sad when a mother forgets her children. And that can be solved too.
Well, I think the first bit of advice would be to really pay close attention to the development of artificial intelligence. I think we need to just be very careful in how we adopt artificial intelligence and to make sure that researchers don't get carried away. Because sometimes what happens is a scientist can get so engrossed in their work, they don't necessarily realize the ramifications of what they're doing. So I think it's important for public safety that we, you know, governments keep a close eye on artificial intelligence and make sure that it does not represent a danger to the public.
I'm not really all that worried about the short-term stuff, the things that are, like narrow AI is not a species-level risk. It will result in dislocation, in lost jobs, and sort of better weaponry and that kind of thing. But it is not a fundamental species-level risk, whereas digital superintelligence is. So it's really all about laying the groundwork to make sure that if humanity collectively decides that creating digital superintelligence is the right move, then we should do so very, very carefully. Very, very carefully. This is the most important thing that we could possibly do.
I don't think most people understand just how quickly machine intelligence is advancing. It's much faster than almost anyone realizes, even within Silicon Valley, and certainly outside Silicon Valley, people really have no idea. So
why is that dangerous?
If there's a super intelligent, particularly if it's engaged in recursive self-improvement, if there's some digital super intelligence, its optimization or utility function is something that's detrimental to humanity, then it will have a very bad effect. You know, it could be just something like getting rid of spam email or something, and it's like concludes, well, the best way to get rid of spam is to get rid of humans.
You think of like the digital tools that you have, your phone, your computer, the applications that you have, like the fact that, as I was mentioning earlier, you can ask a question and instantly get an answer from Google or, you know, from other things. And so you already have a digital tertiary layer. I say tertiary because you can think of the limbic system, kind of the animal brain or the primal brain, and then the cortex, kind of the thinking, planning part of the brain, and then your digital self as a third layer. So you already have that, and it's like if somebody dies, their digital ghost is still around. You know, all of their emails and the pictures that they posted and the social media, that still lives, even if they physically, if they died. Over time, I think we'll probably see a closer merger of biological intelligence and digital intelligence.
Before we continue, help us clicking that YouTube like button and subscribe now to our channel. This shows the algorithm that you valued this information. And it helps us spread that message. Sharing is caring. And now, let's continue.
What to do in such a situation? Inform yourself and keep your financial education strong. We from the Compact Group offer our loyal subscribers a free educational portal with firsthand monetary, financial, and economic knowledge. Enter our invite-only Insider Club by clicking the link below. You will get access to first-class information far earlier than the rest. We have prepared a special deal for all our members, where you can access a giant pool of Robert Kiyosaki's financial wisdom for just $1. To find out more, simply click the link below and join our Insider Club absolutely free. But there is more you can and should do. Build up several streams of income. More and more people realize that they have to take their future in their own hands, but they don't know how and where to start. We from Compact offer our Insider Club members unique opportunities. Strengthen your financial muscle and get the edge. Click the link below. Become part of our free Insider Club. No financial obligations. But there's one important thing you have to know. You have to become active. So do it now. Become active and see you on the other side.